Tom Leppard, born Tom Wooldridge 1935, was known as the Leopard Man of Skye. There is some mystery about Leppard's early life, but he was born on 14th of October 1935 either in London or Suffolk. Before his move to the Isle of Skye, he had spent nearly 30 years of his life in military service, first in the Royal Navy, which he joined aged just 15, and later as a colour sergeant in the Rhodesian Special Forces. Mr. Leppard became known as the Leopard Man of Skye after he covered 99.2, or by some accounts 99.9%, of his body in order to make himself look like a big cat prior to moving to the Scottish island of Skye. Mr. Leppard's entire body, apart from the insides of his ears and in between his toes, was covered in a saffron yellow design flecked with black spots. Even his eyelids were tattooed with piercing blue-green feline irises. To complete the leopard look, he had a set of fangs custom made by a dentist. He would often be photographed with nothing on except a small pouch to preserve his modesty, except that it was also covered in leopard spots, so that he gave the impression of being entirely naked. He quoted, "I was based for a time in the Zambezi Valley, which was the biggest open zoo in the world," he recalled. "There were all sorts of animals there. Lions, elephants, and giraffes, but no leopards." In 1987 he took up residence next to a stream and constructed a small hut which he made from beechcombed material. The hut was located by Loch Na Beast. His small man-made hut had no windows, electricity, heating, or gas. The thatch had rotted away, and his makeshift metal sheet roof would not permit him to stand upright. He slept on a bed made from polystyrene board and cooked on a Primus stove, heating up tins of baked beans or ratatouille. For 20 years he coped with freezing winters and plagues of midges in summer, but he insisted that life on the island suited him well. Living on his own, he had to canoe to Isle of Skye every week or two to stock up on foodstuffs, and drop into the local bar, where the locals had grown used to him, and his appearance. The Leopard Man is tattooed from head to toe with leopard spots. He was considered by the Guinness Book of World Records to be the world's most tattooed man until this was taken to extremes by another person in 2006. In 2008, Leopard packed all his possessions into a couple of bin bags and moved into a care home in Inverness, admitting that he was getting too old for the weekly canoe trip to collect his shopping. He had lived a solitary life before moving back to the mainland in older age, quoted saying, "My life hasn't changed much. I never bothered people when I lived in the Bothy, and they didn't bother me, and I'm not really that interested in what else is going on outside." Many thought of him as an eccentric, which we feel personally is untrue. He was simply a man who preferred his own privacy and way of life and did not feel the need to participate or adapt to the modern mad society many live in today. In 2001 it came as something of a shock. It was revealed that a self-proclaimed vampire called Manuela Ruda, aka the Bride of Satan, then on trial for murder in Germany after sacrificing a man on an oak coffin in front of an altar of skulls, had stayed with him during a holiday in Scotland in 1996, claiming that she had been taught to worship the devil and drink blood during her visit. Manuela Ruda was later convicted, and Leppard was appalled by the suggestion that he might have inspired her actions. He responded when asked about this ludicrous suggestion that she expressed an interest in me and told me she wanted to come and visit, he told a newspaper. She seemed like an ordinary teenager. He stoutly denied any satanic proclivities, explaining that he was a Catholic who prayed for 3 hours every day. Interviewed in 2001, Leppard explained that after leaving the military, he found it difficult to mix with ordinary people. "I decided I wanted to be the biggest of something, the only one of something. It had to be a tattoo. I thought if I get the biggest of something and live in a strange way, people might pay me." The tattoos, etched onto his body over 18 months in the mid-1980s, cost £5,500. He sadly passed away at the age of 80 years old, June 12, 2016 in Inverness, and has left a presence I am sure will be shared for many years to come. Quite simply, we believe him living a simple and anxiety-free life of his own preference is what made this man so unique. This was a testament to the man he was and had the courage to choose how to live his own life in his own way.